sick feet to warm me. DJ, please turn down the music. I need more music. I need music.
What's good? Boston, beyond, worldwide, what is popping? What is going on, my guys, my girls, whatever, all y'all out there? This is the Boston VIP show. We are here at Stage Nightclub, voted number one in USA Today as Boston's number one lounge. Drink different, think different. This is the Stage Nightclub, and this is the Boston VIP show here on DirtyWaterNews.com. I am, of course, the indefinable Sterling Golden. Once again, the Lone Ranger of this thing, piloting this thing solo, you know what I mean? And we have here my guest this week, an amazing, multi-talented young lady right here who I love to death. Model, actress, pro-dom, band leader, you know, cheap chili fry maker, you know, whatever you want to call her. Juggalo, I don't even know. Lilith Astaroth, goddess Lilith Astaroth, is in the building this week on the Boston VIP show. Lilith, what is good?
Hey, how's it going, Sterling? It's great to see you.
Great to see you as well, Lilith. I mean that literally. Great to see you. You know how it is, you guys. Now, Lilith here is on major business this weekend in the Boston nightlife scene because tomorrow night in, of all places, Revere, Massachusetts, a place you don't hear about too often on Dirty Water News, Revere, Massachusetts, the band SORROWSEED, a band of heavy metal warriors that Lilith Astaroth leads proudly, performs tomorrow night. What's going on with this show, Lilith? Tell us.
Well, I'm pretty excited. This is our first home show in a while. We've been doing a lot of out-of-state stuff because we've been on tour. So it's really exciting to be able to hit the home base again. We're going to be on Revere Beach over at Sammy's Patio. It's going to be our first show there. And they've got a really good metal scene going on over there. Killer Robot Promotions, they do shows on the regular over there, and you know they've been trying to get us down for a show for a while, and the stars aligned, so we're gonna be hitting that shit hard tomorrow night with a bunch of other really good local metal, and I'm really pumped about it.
It's gonna be exciting stuff, you guys. If you are a metal fan, if you're a metal head, you know, if you just love to support our Boston music scene, SORROWSEED is your move tomorrow night in Revere at Sammy's Patio. Lilith Astaroth leading SORROWSEED into battle on stage tomorrow night, you know. And also, I want to go a little bit further back about the Lilith Astaroth story for you guys. For those of you out there who may not know a lot about this amazing lady, for the newbies out there, Lilith, for the Dirty Water News faithful, who is Lilith Astaroth?
Who isn't Lilith Astaroth?
Awesome answer.
I mean, I wear so many hats. I like to do a lot of different things, and I like to kick ass and conquer at the mall. So I do a whole lot of things. I mean, if you're a local in the Boston area, you've probably seen me around at the goth industrial scene. I go-go dance over at Machine. I have a residency every Monday night at the Attic. Shout out to DJ Kuro.
What's good, Kuro? What's good, man?
It's hands down my favorite goth industrial night, probably in the entirety of New England, with honorable mention to Dusk down in Providence. That's my other favorite. So if you're a regular goth industrial fan, you'll probably see me at one of those events, whether it's hosting, domming, go-go dancing, one of those things. I like to travel. I love to travel, so I do whatever I can when I'm traveling. I model. I dance, I sing, of course. One of my favorite international events would have to be Montreal Fetish Weekend.
Ah, yes.
Pretty excited about that. This year I'm going to be modeling for Rubenesque Latex, and that's going to be, I believe, the first weekend in September.
Yes.
So if anybody wants to have a really good time up in Montreal, you got to check that out. You've never seen anything like it.
Excellent. Yeah. You know, this is going to be a great opportunity for anybody out there in Montreal, internationally, anywhere. If you're into the fetish scene of Boston, you want to be at Montreal Fetish Weekend. Once again, the dates, please.
I believe that's the first weekend of September, and they do like kind of all weekend. I think it's like the 5th through the 9th or something like that. It's like they start on Wednesday, which I usually get there Thursday, but they go straight till Monday. It's cool. They know how to party up there. I will tell you that right now, and it's a very accessible trip from Boston. It's only 5.5 hours or so. So if you're in like anywhere within New England, you can get there in half a day. It's so worth the trip.
Absolutely.
I mean, it's a party you'll never forget. So
that's right. We'll have more on Lilith Astaroth after the break here on the Boston VIP show, including a revolutionary new film role she's involved in, involving a most unique new film project on the way soon. More on that after the break. We're going to pay some bills here on the Boston VIP show. Back in a few, you guys. Look who's back, you guys, from paying the bills. This is the Boston VIP show. Indefinably, Mr. Golden in the building. Lilith Astaroth, redefining indefinable on the daily. That's you, Lilith. You already know, you know? Now, I mentioned before the break that Lilith Astaroth has an upcoming film role that's pretty unique, actually. This film itself is a unique take on things. And for the first of a couple of new film roles she has coming up, I want to talk about Point in Society. First and foremost, tell us all about Point Society, Lilith.
Point Society is a project I'm really happy to have been a part of. It's actually based on a comic book by Beth Conrad Brown, who's a very, very talented visionary, I could say. It's premiering up in Manchester, New Hampshire on May 15th.
I'll be there.
And awesome, we're doing like a big kind of screening and then like a celebrity gala. She's got a bunch of mini celebs coming out to the night. It's going to be really fun, red carpet kind of stuff. But my character on Point Society is Crow. A little bit of a different kind of role than I'm used to playing. She's got some BDSM kink aspect to her, but everyone in Point is either kind of like one of the puppets or one of the puppeteers. And so she starts off being one of the puppets, which is a little bit of a role reversal for me, because usually I'm the puppeteer, you know. But I couldn't say no to the opportunity that was presented. It looked like an amazing project. I read the comic. It's really cool. If you like dark, twisted, creepy shit that's full of corruption and murder, you're going to want to check out Point Society. So check it out. Look it up on Facebook. Look it up on social media, and you'll find it. It's coming.
It's coming at least once, you know?
Multiple times, actually.
Yes. Yes, people.
That's how we do things around here.
He knows. People, as an old friend of mine once used to say on the radio, what's your fetish? Point Society is your fetish, and it's coming soon. And it's going to be a dope new film experience. But that's not all, you guys. But wait, there's more. Yes. Lilith Astaroth has another film role coming up, and another new film on the way soon. Lilith, what's going on with this new film?
Well, I'm really excited about this project as well. This one's called Witch Hunt, and it's by Boston Film Family. Rick Chandler wrote up his most twisted, sick, disgusting, creepy plot, and I am very pleased to say that I have a lead in this film. It's a short film. It's about witch hunters, but they're corrupt. They've been corrupted since they were kids. It involves, you know, you follow the story of this brother and sister, and they went to a Catholic school where the nuns were corrupt, and the nun ends up cutting out the sister's tongue. So that corrupts them right from the start. So they are these witch killers, but they're also really fucked up. So my character is Morgan, and she's kind of like the queen, you know, which obviously is a much more suiting role for me. She's an evil satanic witch. She fucks with the protagonist using voodoo. She's pretty evil. So I'm really looking forward to this. It's going to be filming at the end of the summer. We're scouting out some locations now.
Cool.
Very excited about it. Keep an eye out for Witch Hunt Boston Film Family. You can find that on my Facebook page, which is facebook.com/LilithAstarothOfficial.
Yes.
And you can find all of the news there. You can also find me on Twitter and Instagram, all that stuff, you know. One thing that we know about each other is we're both really on top of the social media.
That's right. You guys, Lilith Astaroth, making things happen. The Boston music and nightlife and film scene as well. Hollywood East runs wild and lives on through Lilith Astaroth. Lilith, thanks for being here this week on the Boston VIP show. So when we come back, you guys, we'll have more on next week's show. We're going to go make out right now, but in 2 minutes, we're back to find out what's going on with next week's Boston VIP show. Welcome back. Back on the Boston VIP show, you guys. A little rundown what's going on next week, as well as some more info from Lilith Astaroth as well. Goddess Lilith Astaroth in the building. Right here, we have here the cover girl of the latest issue of Dirty Water News magazine out there right now on the streets of Boston. And there it is. She's rocking and rolling it all night and partying every day. This is Miss Felicia Figueroa. And that's a nice shot of the back cover. There it is, and there you go right there. The cover of Dirty Water News magazine in all her splendor. Felicia,
nice.
What is good, baby?
What's going on? How are you?
I am told well. I am told well. Felicia, welcome to the show.
Thank you.
I understand next week you'll be joining us, and you'll be handling some co-hosting duties with us.
Absolutely. I'm so excited. I'm a little bit nervous. It's my first time doing it, but bear with me because we're going to have a lot of fun. Definitely.
You already know. Before we get to more of that show next week, Lilith, you have some more tidbits on some upcoming projects and shows you have coming down the pike.
That's right. Well, SORROWSEED is going to be playing another round of shows next month. We're doing a doubleheader weekend at the end of May. We're going to be playing down at Sammy's Patio again on the 30th. So if you miss tomorrow night's show, you have another opportunity to come and see us down at Revere Beach. And then the very next day, we're going down to hit our favorite Providence venue, Dusk, for the Metal Cage local New England metal compilation show. It's going to be a bunch of New England area bands. It's going to be a good time. So if you miss us this time around, you get another chance to see us again. So
we
want to see you guys out there. And I have another project in the works. We're still writing for it right now. It's called Angor. And that's going to be some really sick, thrashy, metal, chuggy, like, think Slayer kind of stuff.
Like it, yeah!
SORROWSEED is more of a theatrical sort of, like, melodic doom metal band, black.
Yes.
But this project is going to be really straightforward, just straight up death metal, so.
I'm loving it, you know, guys. Like McDonald's, I'm loving it, you know. Next week, on the Boston VIP show, along with Felicia Figueroa, we will have as our guest. You love her in Boston. She is red hot right now. And you love these red hot ladies right here. Well, here's another one for you next week. MB Padfield is here right here next week on the Boston VIP show as our guest. Myself and Felicia Figueroa will be chopping it up and chatting with MB Padfield 1 week from this weekend here on the Boston VIP's show. Until then, you guys, keep the faith, because in Sterlingtology, y'all can trust Indefinable, Sterling Golden, Lilith Astaroth, Felicia Figueroa. Help me out, you guys. Look at me. Hard work, right? What a hard life I live.
It's true.
Peace. Good night.
Good night.
The man, you say?
The man.
music feed to Almighty Jay-Z. Please turn up the music. I need more music. I need music feed to Almighty Jay-Z. Please turn up the music. I need more music. I need.
If you love the music but you can't get it,